Hello everyone, welcome to Research Circle YouTube channel. First of all, thank you so much. We have crossed 4500 plus subscribers and it is still counting. Our today's topic is all about predatory journals. Now from many days I was thinking to create one video on this predatory journals list, because every month Scopus is releasing discontinued journal list. This month means February 2021 also, Scopus has released one more discontinued journal list in which total 18 journals were new which are discontinued, which are highlighted in orange. So shockingly, I thought that the reason for discontinuation for the journals are most of the like publication concerns. That means many articles, or we can say the bulk articles, are getting published in the journals, and that is the reason that these journals are getting discontinued. So predatory journals list is increasing and it is very popular in the market, and people are moving toward these predatory journals. The reason is they are taking money, but they are publishing the articles. But yes, some authors are very keen because they are looking for indexing. I have seen many journals which have indexed the articles, and later on, after 1 month, 2 months, those index articles are unindexed because articles were published in predatory journals. So I was going through some stuff and watching some videos that how these predatory journals are identified. So some studies has been made which I would like to put in front of you. Now this is the first article which is published in nature.com, and as everyone knows, Nature journal is the top journal among all the journals available in the scopus.com. Now maintaining the integrity of Scopus and its high quality curated content is of paramount importance to the Scopus. But and Scopus, I can say that, is a vigilant in identifying and discontinuing journals that are or have become predatory. This Nature has recently published an article based on research looking into the predatory publishing, which they have used Bill List as a definition for predatory journals. Bill List has not been maintained since 2017. I also went through the Bill List and I saw that many updation hasn't been done. So what Scopus has done, with the reference of this research paper which is published in Nature, and also one of the article which is based on the study from 2017, that the Scopus Contest Selection and Advisory Board immediately re-evaluated all the Bill List journal in Scopus. You can see one more article which is available here. Here they have told us how the predatory journals are identified. Basically, Scopus is following three-step method. First method is they are identifying all the journals which are available in Bill's list. Then they are going for checking the ISSN.com website, which is international serial numbers. ISSN's long form is International Standard Serial Number. So they are watching that website also and finding how many articles are published by which country and how many articles are indexed in scopus.com by looking at the Bill's list. So process is very simple. The first, they are identifying all the standalone and the publishers journals which are available on Bill's list. Then they are going for ISSN.com and identifying those ISSN numbers for those journals. Then they are checking how many articles were published in those Bill list journals. And then again checking how many articles out of those published articles are indexed in scopus.com, and we will get the number of papers which are published, and ultimately we are leading toward the predatory publishing journals. So in this way, Scopus is assisting to find out the list of journals. Now they have also launched one more software which is called as a radar software, which is identifying highly published article journals, and through that they can also find out the predatory journals also. Now we can say that the Scopus has acclaimed independent and transparent selection process to determine which journals are indexed on its platform. And we also know that it has an independent content selection and advisory board, which we called as an CSAP. Okay, which is made up of world leading experts in their fields. Now, determining if a journal is predatory or not is a very complex process, that we also know that. Because usually what we do, if we want to verify the journal is active or not, and also whether it is genuine or not, what we do, usually we send an email to Scopus We have a Scopus support at @elsewhere.com. This is an email ID. We put an email to them, or we usually chat on Scopus.com and ask them whether the journal is active or not. Second way is, we usually go on Scopus.com and search the journal by ISSN number and then check whether it is showing as a present or like earlier year is available there. Also, we are checking whether the articles of the current year is indexed in Scopus.com or not. So these are few methods to check whether the journal is active and predatory or not. Also, we go on Google.com and search for the journal and see whether two different websites are available for the journal or not. Fourth method is also there, that we usually go on Scopus.com, search the journal by ISSN number and check whether the Scopus journal homepage from that Scopus.com is moving toward the actual journal homepage or not. So these are some methods. Now, Scopus had declared some statements on their blog also and on Twitter that the customers want access to the most up-to-date and highest quality interdisciplinary content there. And Scopus has clearly stated selection policy and internationally acclaimed board of selection expert. So anyone can be sure that what you see on Scopus meets your high standard. And I wish all the best to the Scopus, and we hope that this predatory list will get removed very soon, and that will lead to the publication ethics and high quality research will be available to everyone. So that's it for today's session. Thank you so much for everyone for watching this video, and you can subscribe to our Research Circle YouTube channel and can also download the Research Circle app. Thank you so much.